back. Nice to have you back in town.
Oh, yeah.
See you.
Hello. Good morning, Mr. President. Morning. Welcome back.
Good morning, Mr. President. Welcome back.
Of a funeral of a cowboy who had been caught in a stampede, and did the head man, the foreman, there, and in this big piece, and then decided to do the single thing of the foreman who is there looking down at the grave. In the, that's the way he is in the big one, and he did that, and Mac thought maybe that with decoration that we have here that I might appreciate having it out alone, so he's loaned it to me.
Two waves.
Very attractive.
Two waves of photography, so don't give away any secrets.
Well, I'm taking a picture.
You guys are back up today then, so they can get out.
I guess it's the last time you and I
the last time you and I involved in the last year.
It really is a difficult thing. I once read a Swedish doctor
at the
Army General's Hospital made a study of the effect of death
bites.
And he was recommending that public officials, I guess some investors, people more than anyone, really should be
Mr. President, are you sorry that you sent up the Mavericks out now to the Congress?
I'm not going to take any questions here. I'll be talking enough, I think, at 8 o'clock tonight.
You're going to send the Persian Gulf report to Congress today?
I got to be fair. I'm not going to take any questions.
We can't even tease you into answering.
Last days. Thank you.
Oh, I got spoiled
with
all that delightful
undress.
I never
asked any
questions.
This way, please.
We had it muzzled.
Very nice. Thank you. Percy.
Well, first about this and about the summit that I'll be reporting on tonight. You know, there's a... I will be saying tonight that...
Hello, President. I'm Andy Lassen. Very nice to meet you.
Cynthia Gwila. Krista. How are you tonight?
Fine.
It's very nice of you to have us come in.
Well, why don't you come here in the middle and then you do it in front and we have a chance.
Well, that's very nice. Thank you.
Turn around, Krista, so the photographers can see.
We hope that you're going to come to Moscow to see us.
Well, if you'll come here, I had agreed to go there.
That's great. Looking right here, that's good. Thank you.
But Geneva, we agreed that the next summit would be here and then finally I would go there for one. Well, so we have a bet in the family that I'm going to get to come back first because I get to come back if there's a summit. Andy's going to be very jealous.
And there's going to be a very sad lady in Moscow. I told him he's going to have to bring us some nice presents.
What's your betting? You thinking maybe we'll do a
chance? I think there's going to be a summit. I can't believe it. Not after all that's taking place.
You got a time and a place worked out? Have you got a time and a place?
No, we're waiting to hear the time. And, you know, what? It's up to him. The invitation's there. When will he give a date? And he'll come. I have kind of thought I'd like to maybe think of California, let him see a little of America, and if I could convince him that it wasn't all staged.
Well, that was Khrushchev's thing, wasn't it? When he came here and thought everybody had arranged it so he'd only see
the good things,
the traffic jams set up for him.
Flying across the country. They just won't believe.
Then I've also thought that if I had it in California, knowing about those marble palaces that they had in his position along calling beach houses and so forth, to take him up to the ranch and show him our little adobe 1,500 square foot house, he might get a different idea about capitalism.
That's right, that's right.
But wait one minute here. We can't even get it.
Oh my goodness.
Thank you. Something for you.
Well, that's very, very kind. Thank you.
And we just thought that, you know, you might have to carry books around, going to school and so forth, the two of you, and that maybe book bags, they might as well know where you are.
Oh,
look
boy.
At that.
Well, might have something. Okay. Thank you. You've got something for the president, too.
Yeah, well, that's 6 months ago, too. Me and a few of my classmates sent you a letter to the Army Express, which is our school newspaper, and you asked us for a copy of the newspaper, so I brought you.
Well, thank you very much.
Here's an article right here. We looked at all the pictures, and here's an article about a letter to the president.
Well, for heaven's sake, thank you very much. Well, I'm very pleased and proud to have it, and thank you for doing it.
It's funny, there's an article that I've written by kids on what to do if your parents get divorced. And there's another article on how to make money walking your dog. And it's a real comment on kids right now.
All right. So look forward to reading it.
Mr. President, thank you very much. We are looking forward to our opportunity, as you can imagine. It's a great challenge for us. And it's been a tremendous experience covering you for 6 years. I can't leave without saying that. It's been a lot of excitement. We've got another challenge ahead, but it's been an honor and a privilege.
Mike was assigned to the White House when Christoph was 3 months old. And so we used to drive past showing friends Washington, and Christoph would look over and he'd say, there's Daddy's office.
Well, I wish you well.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thanks very much. We'll hope to see you there.
Well, hope so. Thank you. And good luck to you.
He said thank you.
Thank you.
Jim, good to see you.
I haven't seen you in a while. Been back over there.
It's been too long.
Take care.
Thank you very much.
We'll hope to see you over there, Jim. Take care.
Thank you. Bye. Take care of your friend.
Thank you.
Takes care of me.
I bet he does. Thank you, sir.
You bet.
President of Costa Rica.
Yes.
Nice to see you again.
It's good to see you.
Thank you. Very Happy to be here.
Come in, I think you
thank you.
Know most of these people.
John, my hand.
We haven't met. Have you?
The ambassador?
Hello. How are you?
Pleased to see you again, and I very seriously want to talk about the plan. First of all, we welcome you. Your plan, the whole idea of bringing democracy there, but I must be honest and say that I have some reservations and some concerns similar to those of our fellow presidents down there and some of the other your neighboring states. That I feel that there is a possibility that's left open, and maybe it's because I've had too much exposure to the communists over the years, that they could find loopholes in which the aim and the very admirable goal of your plan would not get realized.
I thought, if it's all right with you, Mr. President, we'll put a picture of the three of you together, and then we'll divide it out. Now, if we Mr. President,
his wife has been very active in the medical school area.
And many years ago, I appeared in the one-act play contest there at the School of Speech, representing Eureka College.
Did you get the family?
And we did well.
All of them.
In the competition. And then also I returned as a sports announcer.
What'd you do?
Broadcast a few games from Dyke Stadium.
Is that right? Were we winning then or losing?
We didn't get to
both.
You
got
the three.
One of the toughest games in Minnesota. And by the end of the game, tied 34-34. And by the end of the game, there was not a single man on the field that had started the game. They started to send in a substitute for a tackle, injured tackle on Minnesota. And he was already a substitute that was in there. So in comes the third string man, and Bronco Nagurski sent him back to the sideline. He was the only man. I should have said that Bronco was the only man who had started the game and was still in it. And he sent the man back and said, tell him to send out my substitute for fullback. And he moved up into the line and played tackle.
Did he really? Isn't that amazing?
Ms. Ritter, don't you want to come up here and...
I'll get Mr. and Mrs. Ritter together now with you.
All right, we'll be pretty here in the middle.
Well,
thank you. Now one more with this, you and Mr. Ritter together.
Oh, all right.
All right.
Okay. Now
thank you.
Well, I'm going to get one with you in the president.
I'm with an ambassador.
I just became one. I'm very interested to say, and now I'm looking forward to
Well, and I'll tell you, they've stood by us in a great many things.
Great
help. Appreciate it. Great help.
John has done a tremendous job at the SEC, Mr. President. He really has.
I've been here longer than any other chairman, so I figured I better get out before they drag me.
Well, I'm glad you're going to do this. I appreciate it very much. That's a most important country to us.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Right. And we don't want you to forget it, so there's just something to take along.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you very much.
You bet.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hey there, Mr. President. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you. My wife, Sarah,
nice to see you.
Thank you. And my daughters, Catherine, and Paige.
How do you do?
And Elizabeth.
Hello.
Well, maybe one or two of you come over on this side.
All right.
Lead them things up.
Yeah.
Do it like that.
Yeah.
Very interesting place.
And an era is making Bordiva's coming to an end. Please give him my regards.
I certainly will, and thank you very much for this opportunity.
Thank you for doing it. There's 1 minute here. Whoops. This is souvenir, so you won't forget this.
Thank you.
Cufflinks would do for many of you that maybe. Whoops, these pins.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful. Yeah.
Good luck. Thank you.
Thank you again, President.
Nice to meet you.